It's a positive film. It has heroes and villains, and that it essentially is a fun movie to watch. It's been a long time since people have been able to go to the movies and see a sort of straightforward, wholesome, fun adventure.
Well, it's a fantasy. It's not science fiction so much as it is space fantasy. And it's about people. It's finally about people and not finally about science.
The story, when you actually put it into words, is only so much nonsense to hang a great visual experience onto. It's the stuff that fairy tales are made of.
Sort of boiling down religion into a very basic concept. The fact that there is some deity or some power or some force that sort of controls our destiny, works for good and also works for evil.
Marvelous, healthy innocence. Great pace, wonderful to look at, full of guts, nothing unpleasant. I mean, people go bang, bang, and people fall over and are dead. But, you know, no horrors. A sort of wonderful freshness about it, a kind of like a wonderful fresh air.
It's got whatever you want it to be. It's pure entertainment. It's like a roller coaster ride, and it can be interpreted as long as you enjoy it, which is the intention.
Hello, welcome back to Generation Skywalker. You're listening to Gift. What Gift? Now, this is in conjunction with Modern Way. This is our Star Wars present guide for 2020. And joining me, as always, on the Modern Way are Mark. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening.
We've got Craig. Good evening, Craig.
Ho, ho, ho.
Oh, jolly. And we've got Dan. Good evening, Dan.
Good evening.
Now, this is the first podcast of the month. We've got quite a few Christmassy and festive seasonal shows coming, but we thought we'd start the month with a present guide. Now, these, whatever age group your children may be, your large children, it might be an adult, we thought we'd give you some suggestions of things that are available in the UK to buy with what we recommend for different age groups. So we will be going through four different age groups and giving you our top five options for that. Now, boys, we're all in our 40s. Do you boys still receive Christmas presents to do with Star Wars? There's still Star Wars under your tree?
Yes. The problem is, and this is the big issue with me, is people think it's easy because, oh, but just buying something Star Wars. But I'm very picky. So I end up with a lot of tat, stuff that I don't use. Like, I've had all sorts over the years, like doormats and Star Wars socks and, you know, stupid things that, you know, just end up going back in a box. So whilst on paper, I should be very easy to buy for, actually, I'm very, very picky about what I have. Yeah, I do get a lot of Star Wars stuff, not a lot of it that I actually use or want.
To be fair, Star Wars socks are pretty useful, aren't they? Socks are socks, aren't they?
Well, I guess so, yeah. But I'm not one for wearing, like, jokey type stuff, if you know what I mean. Like, socks with funny patterns on. I'm very plain Jane super brain.
You're leaving yourself wide open here.
It's not the first time, mate. It's not the first time.
Well, so, Dan, I take it we're all a bit like Mark, you know. I've received a Star Wars doormat, in fairness to him, and I've received a Death Star chopping board, and I've received all sorts of things. I should think we're all like that, because when you're so invested in something, you do get these things under the tree. Are you as unappreciative as Mark?
No. Oh, Emma's quite good. She does. She listens throughout the year to my hints, and I quite often get things that I've dropped subtle hints on. Yeah, but other times I do get. I think I've got some various stuff that's in the loft now waiting to be sold that I've received that I've gone, oh, thank that. Yeah, not from her. Oh, well, just in case she does happen to listen to this.
Well, yeah, and Craig, I'm taking it you get a few little bits and pieces.
Yeah, it's not like people buy me things for the collection, because like Mark, I think people know I'm fussy. Well, the excuse is, well, you know, I don't know what you've already got. But yeah, like everybody, I get the occasional novelty or a useful thing. Boys used to buy me annuals and colouring books and stuff like that. I think at the height of my cosplaying exploits, Kimberly got me the Jedi dressing gown, which I quite like. But what she's really good at is buying experiences. So in the past, I've got tickets for The Empire Strikes Back Secret Cinema. And when the Secrets of the Empire was down at Westfield in London, I got the tickets for the VR experience. So very good at sort of buying things to do rather than sort of branded tat.
Now, I would say out of everybody, you've got a partner that gets involved in the hobby as well, though, haven't you? She comes to celebrations and stuff with you. So she's not, I'm sure all our partners support a hobby, but yours probably knows a little bit more about what the right things are.
Yeah, I guess she's a bit more on it.
Yeah, well, nice. Let's take it for the last 5 years. Let's just have a positive outlook. What is the best Star Wars gift you've received in the last 5 years under the tree, which you weren't expecting? Like my wife sometimes says to me, I don't know what to get you this year. So I will find a mint on card or something that will arrive and she'll put it under the tree. So, yeah, something you weren't expecting that you managed to get under the tree.
I got a Kota Bokia, you know, the art effects, the half scale, the Emperor and his throne. So Emma got me that a couple of years ago. So that's in my display. It was a nice surprise.
Yeah, nice. Craig?
Yeah, well, I think I've already mentioned it. I think under the tree that I wasn't expecting was my dressing gown, which I still wear.
I've got a feeling you've posted a photo of that somewhere before.
Probably.
Yeah, I'm pretty... Unless it's just something I've just made up in my head for the good times. I don't know. It might be. Mark, so what has been a delight? Is it a Funko?
No, I can't really think of any. The only thing that I can think of is a Last Exit to Nowhere hoodie Rachel the Kids bought me about 3 or 4 years ago. But it was something that I picked out anyway, because Rachel said, what do you want from the kids? So I sent her a link to the hoodie and she ended up getting that for me. So, I can't think of anything really stand out, to be fair.
That's a T-shirt shop, isn't it?
Last Exit to Nowhere. What they do is they do sort of in-joke or sort of very nerdy film and TV show related merchandise, mainly on T-shirts and hoodies and caps and stuff. So, but it's not like overt, it's like brands within films. So they've got like shirts that advertise the Overlook Hotel from The Shining, but they don't mention The Shining.
Okay. I think I've seen them. Haven't they got like a Tyrell Corporation one or something like that? Yeah.
So it's like in joke and basically for anybody that's, you know, a movie buff or a sci-fi buff or whatever, you know, they're really hot on that kind of thing, and other people that are fans of films and TV shows will get it. Great website, great product as well.
So just before we get into our actual present guide, obviously we have listeners from all over the world, but we're basing our present guide on the UK. You know, we don't know enough about these other countries that we can offer that. But UK, where are people looking to make their purchases? So first of all, online, Dan, can you take us through a few of the online places which are good for UK sales?
I mean, just general stuff. You got your Smith's Toys, Argos, Amazon, and then if you want to get into your more, you know, a little bit more specialist with your Black Series and your vintage collection, it's the Star Action Figures, In Demand Toys, Comics and Cocktails, all the usual places we talk about on the modern way.
You've also got Zavvi, carries quite a lot of modern bits and pieces, doesn't it?
Yeah, they're doing a few sales because I'm on their one of their red carpet members, so I'm getting quite a few emails at the minute about various sales that they've got, and I've been flicking through. There's not a huge amount of Star Wars that's going into those at the minute, but they're having things like 80% off sales to clear stuff out. There's a few things popping up.
And obviously places like Shop Disney for getting your, you know, your Disney exclusive kind of items there as well. Yeah. Mark, what about the high street? There is still places which do stock some Star Wars stuff, isn't there?
It's getting thinner and thinner on the ground, mate. Let's be honest. The only place really where I tend to spend any sort of notable money or time these days is Forbidden Planet. We've got one local to us in Hanley Stoke-on-Trent, and it carries a pretty good range. It's a pretty good store, actually, all things considered. But as for anywhere else around here, sort of bricks and mortar shops, there's very, very little left.
Yeah, I suppose your Smiths and your Entertainer are your only real toy shops since Toys R Us are gone, aren't they?
Toy shop's gone, yeah. It's a massive shame, and it's left a massive hole. And you would think, wouldn't you, that toy shops would be relatively safe from sort of high street blues, but obviously not.
Anywhere else you can think, Craig? Obviously, that we've not mentioned the supermarkets. They don't stock a great deal of toys, but you can get your Lego and stuff in the supermarkets and bits and pieces.
Yeah, one that springs to mind that we've not mentioned is probably Waterstones, things like books.
Of course.
Yeah. They carry little bits and pieces, I think, as well this time of year. I mean, it's, you know, one thing I would say, and it's, you know, you're hearing this a lot online, you know, high streets are suffering, particularly local retailers are suffering through the lockdown. And I know it's really hard, but if people can, you know, source things locally, buy it from their local shops, you know, that's a really good thing to do, especially this year.
Yeah, I did also notice while I was Googling around for my list for the present guide, you know, John Lewis holds quite a few Star Wars toys these days. I see bits in Debenhams. And if you're looking for the bargain areas, you know, Home Bargains, B&H, TK Maxx, these places do sometimes stock them, but it's really hit and miss. I mean, you've got to be there in the right time, really, to get anything. But
HMV have normally still got a few novelty items as well, knocking around, other than Funkos.
They do a great range of Funkos as well, don't they? So
Yeah. Set them aside. Let's talk about everything else.
Records and all formats of the movies as well. So, yeah, so there is quite a few places. It's just very thin on the ground. It's not like you used to walk into Toys R Us and you had half an aisle, and those days are gone, because even the toy shops haven't got that, have they? I mean, I go into Gamblers sometimes. Actually, it's just closed down, actually, in Canterbury. But even that, you know, you'd find two or three Star Wars toys. That was it. Things I went into the Entertainer a couple of weeks back just before lockdown. Even in there, there's no turnover of new stock. It's the same things hanging on the pegs that have had it all year in there. You can see why people do turn to the internet, don't you?
Absolutely.
It's late December. It's not a cold night. We're all together, but something's not quite right. There ain't no snow or reindeer sleighs, just pod racers, Banthas, and sand. There ain't no eggnog or carols to sing, just blue milk and cantina fans. It never feels like Christmas on Tatooine. It's just because the heat and the Tusken Raiders stole all our presents, and Jawas took our decorations. This holiday has always been ruined on this desert planet with two suns. Never feels like Christmas on Tatooine.
Right, so the present guide, what we have done is we have split it into four categories: preschool, primary, teenage, adult. And each one of us is going to give you our five countdown of things you can buy. Boys, feel free to chip in when we're talking about the items, especially the stuff you love. I know for a fact that me covering preschool will have Mark pretty excited, I think. It is me gonna start, actually, and I split these into the ages that we've all got a child. I think, Craig, your children the oldest. Mark's the second oldest. It made sense to put him on teenage. Dan, I know Harrison is primary age. And although I have a primary age lad, I do have my daughter who is 3.5. So with that in mind, I thought that was the easiest way for us to draw up these things. So I'm going to start with preschool. And it was really difficult to find stuff. What I will say is things like books and colouring books and activity books, there's loads of them. And also, I haven't put them in here because I've tried to make it a little bit varied, but obviously things like the plusher Baby Yodas and stuff, there's a plush Porg on Disney, they're obvious things, they're great for under the tree, especially if your child is a Star Wars. So I've tried to mix it up and not go too much Baby Yoda, because that's mainly what's around for this age group. My fifth that I put in, which you can find over on Amazon, was the Play-Doh. I don't know if you boys have seen this. You've got the Millennium Falcon. Comes with a plastic tray, which is like a mould. Push your Play-Doh into the mould so you can make parts of the ship. They've got the training ball in there. And it comes with a 5-can heads of Chewie, Leia, Luke, Han and Darth Vader. Play-Doh's always a winner with my children. If I get it out, even my eldest boy will still come and have a little play. And that set there, you know, quite good value for money, £20.90. Like I say, it comes with other moulds, a TIE fighter mould. So there's all sorts you can do with it, X-Wing moulds. And I also have to throw in with it, don't know if you boys have seen the AT-AT Play-Doh as well. Yep. I really like, I probably prefer it to the Falcon. And that's only £11.78 currently on Amazon. Again, it's got the moulds in the side, you know, push a bit of Play-Doh in the sides. It's got, I think, snow speeders and stuff like that, moulds. Any of your boys, I've taken, we've all loved a bit of Play-Doh over the years.
Yeah, these are great. These are great. We've come a long way since we got a little plastic mat, haven't we?
Yeah, and a plastic knife, yeah. Yeah, they are great. This will be quite interesting, actually, because they say a lot of collectors have OCD. Do you let your children mix their colours? Because I know a couple of parents who don't let them. And I just think it's sacrilege. Well, considering a tub of Play-Doh is 99p, isn't it? A couple of quid. I mean, it is really anal when you see people not letting them in. But I think that's a great little stocking filler. Look at the AT-AT. You put it in the body, push it, and it comes out the guns at the front like you're firing lasers. I mean, that's a great, great piece of toy design, if you ask me. Love it.
It's the Play-Doh Star Wars Millennium Falcon playset from Hasbro. Kids can pretend to take on the Empire with the Play-Doh Star Wars Millennium Falcon playset. Mold out pretend battle accessories from Play-Doh modeling compound and arm the Millennium Falcon for battle. You can even make more Star Wars creations, including blasters, TIE fighters, lightsabers, even R2-D2. Use the can-powered firing mechanism to launch your creations, as well as the included can heads to take down Darth Vader. The Play-Doh Star Wars Millennium Falcon playset is for kids ages 3 and up and includes launcher, 5 removable engine stampers, satellite stamper, as well as Luke Skywalker, Han Solo, Princess Leia, Darth Vader, and Chewbacca can head heroes. The Play-Doh Star Wars Millennium Falcon playset from Hasbro.
So that leads me on to number 4. Obviously, when you're looking at preschool, you kind of anything under 5 is what I was looking for. And most of it is for 3 to 5 year olds. But you have to throw something in there for the real little one. Now, this is over on shopdisney.co.uk. This has got to be the cutest dress up outfit you will ever see. It's an Ewok baby costume, bodysuit, dress up. It's clearly Wicket. How great is that? My little girl would love it.
You're leaving yourself wide open here as well.
Well, how cute is that? Yeah, what, for me?
Yeah.
Yeah. I thought this was brilliant. You can get it for 3 months up to 2 years, £26, free delivery.
It's pretty cool.
It's a sweet little outfit.
Yeah.
And then that obviously, there's lots and lots of costumes. So it is a great route, you know, dress up for under fives is massive. I thought, maybe you're a little bit older. Then obviously this one comes straight to mind. This is over on Amazon. The Ruby's Star Wars inflatable Tauntaun costume. You sit in the back, the legs go down the back of the Tauntaun. Looks like you're riding a Tauntaun.
Hang on a minute, Stu. What did you say then? How do you pronounce it?
Tauntaun.
Tauntaun?
Yeah.
I thought it's Tauntaun.
Tauntaun?
Tauntaun.
Okay, well, to tell you what, Mark, I say Tauntaun. Dan?
Tauntaun.
Same as me. Craig?
Tauntaun.
And you're saying Tauntaun, Mark.
Yeah? So, well, closer to Craig's pronunciation.
right here we will insert it exactly how it's said in the film. Okay.
Yeah, get Han Solo saying it, or your Tauntaun will be dead before it reached the first marker. Yeah. That's the line.
Right, let's insert that now.
It's Tauntaun.
Your Tauntaun will freeze before you reach the first marker.
Then I'll see you in hell.
And incredibly, I was right, having listened to that. yeah. But anyway, getting back to it, what a great costume. Although they're not as cheap as they once were. $39.99. It's a great dress-up costume as well, isn't it? I mean, I don't know if I will have a look to see if there's an adult one. I would love to wear that on Christmas Day, trying to cook a Christmas dinner. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Great.
So that leads me on to my third. Now, obviously, these are great stocking fillers, and I didn't realise there were so many of them now, but obviously the potato head range. We've all seen the Star Wars ones over the years, haven't we?
Mm-hmm.
And the current new one for this year is BB-8. Comes with all the parts to build your BB-8. $14.99. But when I started scrolling through Amazon, all these were off Amazon. There's currently quite a few decent ones available. Kylo Ren, $13.99. Stormtrooper, $21.99. 3PO is £26. Luke Frywalker, like that. Bit of play there with the potato thing. That's £25. Yoda, though, is £34 on there for a Yoda potato head. Whether that's just become hard to get. And incredibly, it's not called Slave Leia, but there is a potato wearing Leia's dress-up outfit, which I was amazed at. I'm really surprised this. Potato heads. There's a Predator potato head. I know it's not Star Wars. I was absolutely surprised to see that there was a Predator one.
You missed the best Star Wars one.
What's that?
Spud Vader.
Yeah, is he still available, though? Some of them aren't available anymore, mate.
Okay.
I thought it was Darth Tater.
You're right.
Okay.
And I'm going back now. Me just saying, oh, he's called Luke Frywalker. Kylo Ren is actually Frylo Ren. I'm just going to check the others now whilst I'm still on it. Oh, there's a Han Solo one on here. $12.99. Missed that earlier. That is the best one I've seen, actually. I mean, who wouldn't want a potato head focus, Mark? One for you. I will have to have a good look later because I can't now find Leia. It's definitely Slave Leia, but it hasn't got anything in the title. You found her?
Princess Leia Captive.
Yeah. Incredible, isn't it? That so of every toy range, it's the potato heads that have decided to give us our Leia in her sexy getup.
Luke, help me take this mask off. Just for once, let me look on you with my own eyes. Evil has a new face. Oops, several, actually.
So the top two are things we've spoken about on the Modern Way. And first of all was the Mission Fleet series. I know I bought some of these back when we spoke about them on the podcast. They're not for the collector. My little girl plays constantly with the Mando, the Baby Yoda and the speeder bike all the time. It's now in her toy box. She's always got it on the go. So the Mission Fleet series is a great way of putting stocking fillers and stuff. $7.99 for the single blister packs, which are basically a figure and something that clicks on their back. $15.99 for things like the Mando set, which comes with the speeder and the Baby Yoda and a few weapons. $19.99 then for the ships, things like the TIE Fighter and the X-Wing. And then the Millennium Falcon, $39.99. All these are still available on the Smith's website and in store. So Smith's is the place to go for them if you want those kind of prices. I think that's a good range of figures. They're quite durable. So, highly recommend them. And my number one, we actually covered on the last episode of The Modern Way. It is the remote control Baby Yoda. So you've got a thing that goes around your wrist. There's a button which you click that and the Yoda will follow you around the house. You press the blue button, you can go and hide. It will come and find you. It's obviously sensitive with that. It talks, it wiggles its ears. Its packaging is a crib. It is £60 and you can only get it on Shop Disney. But if you're looking for cute and you're looking for something that they'll enjoy for a period of time, I'm putting that at the top this year for me. So there is my five. So Play-Doh number five. Four is my dress-up costumes. Three potato heads. Two, the Mission Fleet toys, and one remote control Yoda.
From Star Wars Mandalorian, it's the Child Feature Plush RC. Now you can control where the child goes, or activate Follow Me mode to have the child find you.
So, is your friend staying for dinner?
He'll eat frogs.
It's the Mandalorian Child Feature Plush RC.
So, Dan, you have Harrison. I think he's about six.
He's nine.
Wow, he was six once upon a time.
I know, yeah, it's gone quick.
So we've gone with kind of like a primary age for you, kind of 6 to 10. So what have you got?
So I've gone, well, as you can imagine, for 9-year-olds at the minute, it's pretty much it's 100% Mando heavy, I think. I don't think there's anything there that's not really related to the Mando. So he's all over that at the minute. It was a bit of a shame last Christmas. There was no merch out, really. I think the only thing I could get him was a 6-inch carbonized Black Series figure that people wanted £50 for on eBay. So hopefully this Christmas he's gonna get a bit more Mando. But in terms of the top picks there, so I'll do the same sort of countdown as you, Stu. I've got the Darksaber. So I know I shared a photo on or a short video a few weeks ago of him in Smith swinging around a Darksaber. So he was drawn straight to that. So that's on his Christmas list. I know you've obviously seen it now in the Mandalorian show at the end with Moff Gideon. So I think it's just a replica of that. It's got all the sounds and motions like a normal FX lightsaber. So I imagine he'll be wanting to fight me on Christmas Day morning if he gets that.
Do you know, to be fair, that it's a really nice lightsaber. And incredibly, when I was looking for preschool stuff, it kept throwing it up to me for under fives. I was thinking, my son does make my daughter play lightsaber fights, but I think that's just how you can hammer her with a lightsaber. I did think to myself, I don't know if I'll be buying that for her if she was 4, but yeah.
I think it's the age ranges that come up on some of this stuff, because I think it does say 4+ on the box, so you could, it's probably why it chucks it up.
Yeah, you're right, because there's some Lego sets coming up which were like 4+, and I was thinking, I don't believe a 4-year-old can build that.
So that's $29.99, and that is everywhere. That's in Argos, that's in Smith's, that's on Amazon. I think that's pretty much widely available. Maybe hold out for some Black sales on that. It might drop by £5 or £10 over the next few weeks. And then number 4, I've got the again with the Mandalorian, the Nerf gauntlet blasters. So they're 2 gauntlets. I don't think one of them does very much. It's got a small flame coming out of one side, but the others has got like the are they called the hummingbirds or the singing birds in the show when he launches all the little rockets off. They're kind of like that. There's a cluster of them on the gauntlet, and you press a button and I think it fires off 3 Nerf guns. I think if we were reviewing a toy like that on the normal show, we'd all scoff at it. But I think for a kid of his age, or, you know, 8, 9, 10-year-old, they'll be all over that after seeing the show. So that's my 4th pick. And then my 3rd pick, I have actually gone away from Mandalorian. I did tell a lie at the start. There's the, and we reviewed these as well on the Modern Way, the Celebrate the Saga sets. So these are starting to go on sale now. So none of the collectors wanted them, so you can see the price is slowly starting to fall. So if you can remember, there was 6 sets of those. I won't go through all the different combinations. Sorry, there were 7 sets. So there's various combinations of figures. There's a trooper set, a dark side set, a Jedi set, clone trooper set, a bounty hunter set, a first order set, and then over on Amazon, the other 2 sets you can only get there are the Rebellion set, so that's with Luke, Han and Leia, and then there's the Resistance set, which is your Poe, Rey and Finn. So they're down to $27.95 now, and if you work that out per figure, it's just over £5 a figure. And if you've got a kid into Star Wars, when you look at them at that sort of price range per figure, it's not really a bad deal. They'll probably drop further, but, you know, there's not a lot out there for kids that have already got 3¾-inch at the minute. So if you want to get in some figures, that's probably a good way of picking some up at a fairly reasonable price per figure. And then staying on the 3¾-inch, I've gone back to the Vintage Collection Mandalorian Child Build-Up set. Again, we spoke about that on the last Modern Way show. We gave it a little bit of a hard time because of the face sculpt, but I think any 9-year-old that's into the Mandalorian is gonna take quite great joy in getting hold of a figure and a baby Yoda at the same time. So I think for the price, that's $16.99. Again, all the usual suspects. It's on Star Action Figures. It's on Smith's. It's on Zavvi. It's everywhere at the moment. That's not a bad deal. And then my number 1, which I did flip-flop on a little bit, but I'm going to stick with it now. It's the Lego Laser Razor Crest. So sticking on the Razor Crest theme. It's a little bit more pricey. It's £120 at the moment. That's available in the Lego store, and I've seen it on the Disney store as well. I haven't seen it in Smith's, or not in the actual brick-and-mortar store itself, but it's in Smith's. And that is obviously what it says on the tin. It's a replica of the Razor Crest. It comes with several figures. It's got a Cara Dune, it's got a Mandalorian, a baby Yoda, and a Scout Trooper. So that's my 5.
So you getting the Razor Crest for Harrison?
Yeah. I bought it a while back, and everyone was talking about, oh, they're going to change the name on the box. It's got Razor Crest on the box and they're going to have to change it because there's some dispute over the rights of the name Razor Crest. But I've been looking and it's still called Razor Crest everywhere. So I'm not quite sure what's going on there.
No, I think quite a few have been sold as the Razor Crest. So yeah, people are thinking, I'll stick it away and make a pretty penny. I don't think it's going to be particularly rare.
No.
So Dan, just a quick recap. Can you just count that five down, back to front?
Yep. So we've got in at five, we've got the Darksaber, 4, the Mandalorian Gauntlets, 3, the Celebrate the Saga Packs, 2, the Mandalorian Child Build-Up Pack, and then at number 1, the Lego Razor Crest set.
Right, so that leads us on to, well, we've put it down as secondary slash teenage. So the 11 to 16-year-old, you know, the high school, if you like, kind of phase of their life. And Mark, your son is in that age bracket, I believe?
He's 11, so he's right at the start of that bracket. As with most kids that age, they always tend to think they're about 2 or 3 years older than their actual age. Yeah, teenage is probably just about right, mate.
Right, so what have you come up with?
Well, I'm going to start with a bit of a stocking filler, something cheap and cheerful and, you know, something that doesn't cost a great deal of money. And this is the I've Got a Bad Feeling About This card game. Don't ask me how you play this card game. I tried to watch a YouTube video of it and I hadn't got a clue what was going on. But it looks like you have to do certain things in this card. You kind of try and make sure that you're the last person in, and you have to perform different Star Wars impersonations or acts or say different things. And if for anybody that's a Star Wars fan, absolutely perfect. And that is the cheapest price I managed to find. That was £8, and that was on the Entertainer. So it's a good little stocking filler, that.
I don't know. I have a bad feeling about this.
Number 4 is Mandalorian Monopoly. Now, there's 2 versions of this. There is the Disney Store exclusive, which is £50, or there is the sort of general release of it, which is $42.99, which is available basically everywhere. But if you go for the Disney Store exclusive, and we mentioned this in our last Modern Way podcast, it comes with the exclusive Remnant Trooper from The Mandalorian. Now, if you've got your head screwed on, that's the edition you need to get, because if that's the only way you're going to get that figure, the chances are people are going to be paying £50 just for the figure at some point. So you basically get the game for free. So keep your head screwed on and go for that one.
Now, unlike some other versions of Monopoly, this isn't just a simple new coat of paint on top of the original game. It is its own beast entirely that puts you right in the center of the action, traveling around a dangerous galaxy while Imperial forces threaten the safety of the one and only Baby Yoda. In the game, you can play as the Mandalorian, or Cara Dune, or IG-11. Many of the characters are featured from the series, and when you acquire the Child Token, you can unlock each character's special ability. You buy hideouts, win battles, and earn Imperial credits. The player with the most Imperial credits wins, but watch out! If an Imperial enemy like Moff Gideon gets Baby Yoda, the game is over for everyone. If you are looking for a fresh twist on a classic that is perfect to show off your love of Star Wars, do not miss out on the Mandalorian Monopoly game. It's up for pre-order right now, so go ahead and grab yours.
Number 3 is, now I'm not a gamer, but my lad definitely is, and this is definitely on his Christmas list, is Star Wars Squadrons, a console game. Now, I believe, from what Zach has told me, this is a first-person shooter, so you take on the character of either, you get the sort of chance to play for the fight for the Imperials or fight for the Rebellion, and you get to customize your ship. You choose different ships to go to battle in, like Y-Wings, X-Wings, TIE Fighters. Basically, it's the game we all wanted back in the day, but our children now have got the great opportunity of playing. So, $27.99 at the moment. That's the cheapest brand new version, the brand new copy of that at Curry's is the cheapest I can find now.
That's a really good price, isn't it, for a computer game?
$27.99. I think Game had got it on at $32 or $34.99. It was over £30 anyway.
But when you think of something like FIFA comes out at like £80, doesn't it? It's like,
oh, honestly, I don't know where they get their prices from, really.
Well, not when they've got all these tie-ins now and you've got to buy for this, that and the other when you get the game.
It's gone mental. Absolutely mental.
It definitely had a lot lower price mark than most games, for sure, because most new releases are £50.
Yeah,
from the bat, and yeah, so and it came out and it was 35, so yeah.
Anyone played it? It's got really good write-ups, doesn't it?
Not yet.
I reckon Craig's completed it.
No, Kimberly's the gamer in our house, and she's still on Battlefront 2. I'm not a big gamer, but I do enjoy watching her play, completing the levels and stuff.
Number three is Star Wars Squadrons. I would imagine that if you are a gamer, and certainly if you are a Star Wars gamer, you've probably already got this, but he hasn't got it yet, so I'm going to get it for him. But that's what I recommend.
Jacob, giving engines full power.
Think you can escape?
This is gonna be close.
Strength. We do not accept defeat.
Remember why we fly. For hope. For the New Republic.
Vengeance will be ours. The perfect shot makes history.
Five pilots.
One squadron.
The galaxy's finest.
Number two is DK Books Complete Vehicles. Now, I've had these cutaway books before in the past, and I find them absolutely fascinating. I could look at those illustrations all day and see something new every time I looked at it. The amount of detail that goes into these cross-section books is just amazing. And this one is a amalgamation of all of them put together in one volume. So you can imagine from the prequels, the sequels, and the original trilogy. No Mandalorian in this one, though, which is a bit of a shame. And given the fact that it's only just come out, you would have thought they would have made sure that there was at least some Mandalorian ships in there. I mean, I'd love to see a cutaway of the Razor Crest. That would be fantastic. But there are two exclusive cross-sections featured in this book alone, so you won't see them anywhere else. And one of them is of the Night Buzzard from the sequel trilogy, which is quite a cool, spooky-looking ship. And I don't know how to pronounce this, but the Zeiston class Sith Star Destroyer. I would imagine that's from The Rise of Skywalker. So those two are exclusive to that book. You won't see those anywhere else. Amazing, amazing illustrations. Detail is just fantastic. And I found the cheapest price on Amazon at £24.32. That's not to say that you might not find it cheaper. Perhaps if you go on eBay, you might find one cheaper than that. But at the moment, £24.32 seems like a pretty good price for a book with that much detail and how many cool illustrations you get in there. So yeah, that's my number two. And number five, now I would have number one, sorry, this would be like a main present. So this would be like the big box that you would probably open last on Christmas morning. And I've gone for the Lego Tantive 4, Tantive 8, Tantive, I don't know, I say Tantive. It's always been Tantive as far as I'm concerned. Yeah, Lego Tantive 4. cheapest price for that at the moment is Smith's Toys, $149.99, which, when you add it up, that's quite a decent price for that amount of Lego and that amount of fun. I think we've already covered this on sort of previous shows. One of those Master Builder, so I think it's a Master Builder series anyway. It looks like it's in a similar box to the Critchy Cantina that's just coming out. And I would imagine sitting down on Christmas morning, opening that up and sitting there spending all Christmas Day making that up would be a fantastic, fantastic day and something you would remember for the rest of your life. So, yeah, that's my number one choice.
Brilliant. I'm actually really tempted by that, Tantive.
Now I've got that cantina, mate. I'm tempted by more Lego, and that is number one on the list, and that's why I've put it down there, because I think it's a really good set.
So, Mark, can you just give us that countdown?
Right. Number five is I've Got a Bad Feeling About This Card Game from The Entertainer, £8. Number four is Mandalorian Monopoly, and go for the Disney Store exclusive with the exclusive Mandalorian Remnant Trooper figure. That's for £50. Number three is Star Wars Squadrons console game. Cheapest one for that is Currys, $27.99. Number two is the DK Books Complete Vehicles Cutaway Books, and that's from Amazon at £24.32. And number one is the Lego Tantive 4 from Smith's Toys at $149.99.
Perfect, mate. Perfect. So that leads us onto the final list of Prezi recommendations. And we're going to head over to Craig now. Now, Craig, you got biggest area. You got adult 17 plus for all us big kids and for those kids of ours that are still dabbling like we might dabble.
Yeah, I've tried to look at this in quite a broad way. You know, it's been a tough year. And I think it's looking like a quiet Christmas at home for lots of people. So I've tried to think of gifts that are kind of relevant to what we're all experiencing at the minute, and some things that will help people chill and be a bit kind to themselves over Christmas. So there's a general theme. And my first suggestion in fifth place, and obviously, you know, we're in the middle of a pandemic still, and the virus isn't going to be going anywhere for a while, even though we've got the promise of vaccines on the near horizon. But how about for Christmas giving the gift of staying COVID-free, but with a Star Wars twist? So I'm thinking hands, face, space, ships. Okay, so first you're going to need some hand sanitizer. So what could be better than some Star Wars Clip and Clean hand sanitizer? And these are made by a company called Mad Beauty, and they come in four flavors with four characters. So you've got Chewbacca, who's coconut scented, Darth Vader, who smells of black tea, Yoda, who's cedarwood and lime, and C-3PO, who's amber and ginseng. And these come as small squeezy bottles. They've got a nice character art label on there and a handy little clip so that you can clip it to your keys, clip it to your keyring, clip it to your bag. So you always got that hand sanitizer when you're out and about in town. These are pretty much readily available. I've seen them around. They retail around $3.99, but there's a website called www.lastminutegifts.co.uk, and they've got them for $2.99 each. So you've got your hand sanitizer. What you need to do is you pair it with some face coverings. Now, there are lots of Star Wars themed face coverings out there made by a myriad of different companies. They all come with the disclaimer that they are not medical grade. And this recommendation is not an endorsement by Generation Skywalker that if you wear these, you are not going to catch the COVIDs. But a reliable brand is important with things like this. So I'm looking at Shop Disney, and I'm looking at their pack of four cloth face coverings, which come in four designs. You've got a Baby Yoda kind of graphic. You've got some vintage Star Wars fabric, which is the old bedspreads. There's an R2-D2, and then there's a more contemporary fabric with a pattern of, sort of Star Wars logos and symbols. And what's quite nice about these, and why I've kind of picked them out, not just because they're a recognized brand for something that's quite important, Disney are going to be donating 100,000 of these to some of their charity partners. And alongside that, they're going to present 100% of the proceeds from them with a cap of £500,000 to Red Cross organisations across Europe. So there's an extra little reason to kind of go for those over another vendor of face coverings. So what I'm thinking is you can put this stuff together as a little kind of Star Wars hands, face, spaceship gift pack. And what would be nice would be to put that into a little kind of bag when you present it. So I'm looking at the bags that Loungefly create, and they're a fantastic design-led brand, and they've got a good selection at the moment at geekcore.co.uk, and it's quite hard to pick one really. There's a nice set of bags that have got sort of planets as their themes. There's Tatooine, Hoth and Endor, and they're very kind of graphic and minimal. There's a couple of more kind of masculine sort of messenger bags. There's an X-Wing and a TIE Fighter there, and then there's a vintage action figure pattern little bag. So they range from $67.99 for the action figure bag, the sort of Tatooine backpack type things, they're $54.99. And the messenger bags are $19.99. So my first suggestion for a gift is a little set of three gifts in one. So you're giving a little Star Wars themed COVID safety pack.
Very nice, mate.
So that's the first suggestion. So the second suggestion, and we're going to be talking about this a lot more in an upcoming episode, which I think will be out at the end of the week. But the original Stormtrooper beer, they are smashing it with their gift packs at the minute. As a Star Wars themed Christmassy gift, I don't think you'd go far wrong with a Star Wars gift set of beer. Now, there's a few to choose from. They do a really nice pale ale in a tin, a nice branded Stormtrooper beer tin. And if you've not seen any of these graphics, go and check them out, because it's really nicely done. That comes with a bottle and a glass. That's at $12.99. And they do sort of gift packs that contain bottles and glasses without the tin, but again, nicely branded card packs, and they're $8.49. I'm looking at their website, which is the original stormtrooperbeer.com, but I know a lot of the supermarkets carry in this year, so it's one of those things you can stick in the trolley as you go around and tick your uncle off the list. But yeah, great brand and tasty beer, and we'll be hearing more about that very soon. You're at home, got beer, you want to feel a bit Christmassy, get in the mood, you've got the Christmas lights on, how about something to create a bit more atmosphere? So I'm looking at the official Star Wars candle set. So these are scented candles, and I know they've been out a while, but I'm going to suggest these, put these forward, because there's a really, really good deal on them at the moment at Zavvi. So they should have been $19.99. They're currently $8.99 for the New Hope set, and the Jedi set should have been $24.99. And again, they're $9.99, and you get five candles to light and get in the Christmassy spirit. And they are scented as follows. You get Wookiee, Bantha Milk, Trash Compactor, X-Wing Cockpit, and Cantina. That's the New Hope set. And the Jedi set comes in Rancor, Sarlacc Pit, Jabba's Palace, Ewok, and Destroyed Death Star scents.
Do you think these actually smell like what they're saying?
No. I think they're novelty ways of selling candles to people who don't normally buy scented candles.
I love it. This is a great suggestion. X-Wing Cockpit is going to smell what Jez smells like, that kind of damp. Do you know when your clothes are damp, they're not dried properly?
Yeah.
Yeah, the Jez smell, I call that.
So you've got a beer, got your candles. So that was my third. So my second in the list is Christmas. The family that are around you and are not far away and you're not having to travel to see them need a bit of quality time. And I've picked out the Theory 11 playing card set. Now, I don't know whether anyone's seen these. They were heavily plugged on social media and paid for advertising, kept cropping up in my feed anyway a few months ago. But they're a set of playing cards, but they are the most gorgeous looking things. You know, as a designer, these really, really kind of caught my eye. They come in a light side or a dark side option. So the light side is a sort of blue foiled box. It's very intricate. It's got sort of die cut there of the Millennium Falcon cockpit window. But the cards themselves, the character cards, you know, the Queen, the Jack, and the King, are Leia, Luke, and Han. And the illustrations are just stunning. They really are. They also come in a dark side, which is red. And that's more of your kind of Emperor's throne room feel. And you've got the Emperor, Vader, Kylo Ren in there as the illustrations. And they're a really cool, contemporary sort of twist on the very traditional sort of playing card designs. So you need to see them to get where I'm coming from with them. Now, they're available. They're an American product, but they're available over here from the magicshop.co.uk. And they are also carrying special editions of them. So the light side, they've got a silver edition, and the dark side, they've got a graphite grey. So it's four options there, and they're only a tenner, $9.99. Beautiful, beautiful objects, and something that you can play poker with your grown-up friends and family, or you can play fish with the kids. So something there for the family that's a really, really nice collectible in its own right. So number one recommendation, you know, we don't know how long this kind of in and out, shake it all about lockdown is going to last. So I've tried to look at things again that will add a bit of value to people's lives at home, but also things that are easy to buy. So they don't need wrapping. You don't have to schlep into town. You don't have to go to the post office. These things can be sent and redeemed electronically. So what could be better than the gift of actual Star Wars? So I'm talking the movies, the TV shows, the extra features, and also the expanded universe of novels. So I'm thinking like a special two-pack for your loved ones. So I'm thinking of Disney Plus and Audible subscriptions. So you can gift 12 months of Disney Plus to somebody for $59.99. They can receive it as an e-gift, or if you want, they can send out an actual gift card. But that would give them access to everything on there for a year. And Audible currently, I just checked, has got 236 Star Wars audiobooks listed. All the latest books get put on there pretty much on the day of release. And you can pre-order any upcoming books so you don't miss anything. And you can gift a 12-month membership for $69.99 that gets you 12 free books, which are staggered throughout the year. So you get a credit a month, regardless of how expensive the book is. You can gift 6 months for $47.99, 3 months for $23.99, or 1 month for $7.99. And generally, when you look at these things, you know, to download and own one of the main Star Wars novels, can be around £25 each, so it's a really good deal. Alternatively, you can just gift an individual title to someone. So yeah, if you go on disneyplus.com and audible.co.uk, there are links there to their gift pages, and I think that's a great present this year for people.
Yeah, great choice, mate. Great choice. Joe, what? Really enjoyed your list, actually. I've just ordered myself some candles.
It's a good deal.
Yeah, I think it's a very good deal. I like that. And I like the New Hope one comes with a stand as well. So all over that. Craig, could you just give us that rundown again briefly?
Yeah. So in fifth place, a Hans Face spaceship Star Wars themed COVID pack. Fourth, Stormtrooper beer. In third place, some nice scented candles. In second place, really, really nice pack of cards from Theory 11. And at number one, subscriptions to Disney Plus and Audible.
I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
You refer to the prophecy of the one who will bring balance to the Force.
I need someone to show me my place in all this. The belonging you seek is not behind you. It is ahead.
You must feel the Force around you.
Strong in my family. My father has it. I have it. You have that power too.
The Force. A Jedi. It's all true.
Anyone think anything should have been in there on any of us lists?
I've got a couple of suggestions.
Go for it.
Pre-school, a company called Blades, who are renowned for doing remote control vehicles and drones and things like that. They had the license to produce, and they've been around for a while now, these inflatable Star Wars characters, remote control. So you could get like an inflatable, like quite, some of them are quite big as well. The jumbo ones were Vader, Yoda, the smaller ones you get of Kylo Ren, First Order Stormtrooper, BB-8, and the black round droid like BB-8 from Rise of...
BB
baddie, I don't know.
BB-9, isn't it?
But they're pretty cool. And also, I did the artwork for all the characters, so that's another good reason to actually go out and buy them. And then for the sort of 6 to 10 age range, there was another game that I saw, which I thought was pretty cool stocking filler, which was called Don't Upset the Wookiee card game. This looked actually pretty fun, because what you've got to do is you've basically got to get rid of all your cards by making Chewie more angry. So these little illustrations on these cards go from like him being pretty sedate up to like pulling the arms off a droid. And it just looked like a really, really cool, funny little game. Nice little stocking filler. And it came in a plush Chewie carrier, which I thought was another cool little point to it. And that was only 15 quid from John Lewis. So keep an eye out for that one. And then the 17 plus, one thing that I did see when we visited London last, we were in Harrods, and they just released these, you know, the Star Wars and the Pop Art Lego things, where you've got like a basic board and you've just got like loads of little coloured dots.
Oh, yeah.
And you make up the pictures to make up like a pop art picture. And I remember seeing they got like Marilyn Monroe in there, the Beatles. I think they did a Jimi Hendrix one. James Dean, I think, might have been one of them. But they've got Star Wars one, and there's a Star Wars set called the Sith set. And if you buy three of them, you can make up a really large Darth Vader image. But they're not cheap. They're £99. But my God, they really do look cool and very satisfying to sit down and do, I imagine, as well. So yeah, that's what I would add to the mix, I think.
It's funny you bring those. They're made by Lego, aren't they, those little
Yes,
things?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, so back in the 80s, they used to get, they were like a little kind of, like a foil type thing, which you used to push onto a board as well, and they used to make pictures. This has got nothing to do with Star Wars, just reminds me. But I've got two sisters, the younger of my two sisters, she's 3 years older than me, and she'd got this picture bought from her by my mum and dad with these foil things. She went to bed Christmas night, and my dad did it all. So when she woke up the next morning, the whole picture was just completed. He was like, I did it for you. She's like, brilliant. She brings it up every year, but
that'd be something that I would do.
Yeah, handmade. It's a good one, but yeah, nice suggestions, Mark. A few different bits and pieces as well. Craig, Dan, anything to add?
I think you can't go wrong with a geeky tiki mug and a Star Wars steelbook.
I hope I've got a geeky tiki somewhere in my stocking this year. I've dropped enough hints. We will see.
You better watch out.
You better not cry.
You better not call on yours, Jedi.
The Empire is coming to town.
We have a Death Star.
We tested it twice.
Tracking down rebels and ending their lives.
The Empire is coming to town.
I have a very bad feeling about this.
It's kind of gross.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not call your dad. The Empire is coming to die.
Moving on from our Christmas present guides. Thank you, boys. Brilliant job. Now, this was suggested by you, Craig. You said that it'd been a really tough year for so many people. You know, there's people have lost their jobs this year and people haven't had full wages and whatnot. And some people have been sitting at home for months now. So we thought we'd have a look at some of the independent businesses and some smaller items, some good stocking fillers and areas of Star Wars that we wouldn't normally cover and you don't really hear covered on other podcasts. So just wanted to hear what we'd all brought to the table here, what we'd gone out and found, because there is lots of little businesses doing crafts, doing their own arts and selling their wares, and some of it is so creative and so imaginative that they sometimes deserve a shout out as well. So I'll come to you first, Craig, because this was your suggestion for areas that you've found.
The first independent business I want to shine a light on is a company called Frilly Industries. Primarily, it's a lady called Kirsty who runs this enterprise, and she hand makes all of this jewelry herself. But what she does do is a set of kind of Star Wars themed wooden pins. And I like these because they're just, they've got a really sort of indie lo-fi kind of vibe to them. I think, you know, they're very, very different from the kind of run of the mill kind of bits of Star Wars merchandise. And she's sort of got a little focus on some of the hunks of the franchise. So she's got Harrison Ford pin, the John Boyega pin, Oscar Isaac, and Adam Driver. And I spoke to Kirsty earlier today and she dropped me a little note back, and she said these are created from FSC certified wood from a local sawmill, and she can take custom requests too. So however obscure your favorite character, she can create one of these for you. And she describes them as a way to stay classy with your pin game and rock your Star Wars love with a wooden pin badge drawn with lasers. Great little kind of stocking fillers, I would say, for boys and girls. And these retail at a tenner a go, so nice and affordable and sustainable, and you are giving a helping hand to a small business in a tricky year. So that would be my first recommendation.
Very nice.
And the next company that I want to talk about is a company called Geek Boutique. And I don't know whether people might have come across this business, because I know that they exhibit a lot of the shows. But it's a company that makes a range of items from kind of fabrics that are all themed in genre and pop culture properties. And her Star Wars range is fabulous. And I don't know whether anyone remembers the collecting track presentation that we did. But I was sporting one of Geek Boutique's shirts. It's the fabric that's been made out of the graphics from the old Marvel comics. So they do these dresses, cushions, purses, whatever, out of kind of modern fabrics, but they also do items made out of vintage offcuts and things. So on their site at the moment, there's a couple of cushions made from old Return of the Jedi bed sheets, and they're on there for £17 each. Little bits and pieces like hair bands for £8, a couple of great dresses for the Star Wars lady in your life. But one of the really smart sort of cute things is they've got little handbags made out of recycled VHS cassette boxes. They've kind of upcycled these old cassettes and put straps on them and created little handbags, and they retail at $19.95. And the last company that that I stumbled on that I really, really want to give a shout out is on Etsy. And it's a maker called Pam Crafted UK. And let's presume she's called Pam. She creates lots of kind of knitted and sort of little bits and pieces of kind of crochets and metalwork, little buttons. And we've all seen, you know, crocheted Star Wars characters, but these are just a step above. I mean, she's got a Chewbacca on there priced at £33.50. And it's just beautiful. It's got such character, and it looks so well made. The characters have also been translated into baubles, so the Chewbacca bauble is equally beautiful, but that comes as a pack of four with a Porg, R2 and 3PO, and that's $7.95. So that's, you know, that's a great buy for the amount of work that's gone into those. So yeah, I'd really recommend people check out this seller on Etsy, Pam Crafted UK.
Like those. I love that layer, actually. She's that's what I mean. That's just so imaginative, isn't it? Someone's...
And the Jawa's nice as well. The Jawa's so cute.
Yeah, brilliant. You can even have a COVID bauble offer.
Yeah.
Which is always going to be enjoyable. Yeah, go and check those out. We will make sure links are provided. So, Mark, you looked at a bit of a different way. I think you've gone for independent shop.
I just want to give a bit of a shout out to those guys who've got bricks and mortar shops in what is undoubtedly the, you know, just the worst time for bricks and mortar retail. First guy I want to just mention is a guy called Jez Davis. Now, if you are a vintage collector specifically, or just, you know, toy collector, you will more than likely have come across this guy. He does toy fairs up and down the country and attends things like Echo Live and Farthest From, and he's a lovely guy, really friendly, and he has a bricks and mortar shop in Blackpool called Jawa Unique Toys, and that's on Church Street in Blackpool. I think he's recently moved there from another shop that he had, And we went, I remember going in last year it was, and I just couldn't believe it. It's just so cool to see collector shops like this on High Street. And it was stuffed to the gunnels with vintage toys, Star Wars from every era, Action Man, He-Man, Thundercats, everything, plus new stuff as well. And upstairs, he'd actually got a lot of his collection on display, and I got to see his collection, and he's, honest to God, it's just amazing. And he's still got this bricks and mortar shop, and he's still going. He's been going for many years, and I just wanted to give him a big shout out. And hang in there, mate. Hopefully good times around the corner. And the second guy I want to give a big shout out to is another vintage collector, specifically is a guy called Andy Van Dyke, who I guess, again, a lot of you will have seen on Facebook and events like Echo Live and Farthest From, and a lot of the toy shows up and down the country, like the NEC, Birmingham. Really, really friendly guy, approachable, lovely guy to talk to, really knowledgeable. And he's just set up a bricks and mortar shop in Hertfordshire, Rickman's Worth, to be specific, on Uxbridge Road. And his shop is called Toy Vault UK. And he's got a little shop, little collector shop. He's doing just vintage stuff mainly, but everything from figures to magazines and all sorts of bits and bobs in there. And if you get a chance, go on Facebook and do a Facebook search for Toy Vault UK, and you'll see some of the images of his shop. And it's so cool. I think anybody who's got the balls to set up bricks and mortar retail at the moment, you need to support them absolutely. Any way you can. It takes a lot of guts. Hopefully he's going to be around for a while to come. So good
luck. He's 10 minutes down the road from me. I was going to go on, I think it opened Halloween weekend, didn't it?
Yeah, it was.
And then 3 days later, we went into lockdown. So yeah, I will be heading down there once he opens up again.
He'll be open up once lockdown's open. It's definitely worth a visit, mate, especially if you're on the doorstep. But if you go, I'll try and meet you down there, because I've promised him I'll go down and visit. It's a bit of a jaunt for me, but I'm prepared to make the trip, because the shop looks like it's definitely worth the miles.
I set it up.
Great to give these places a shout out. I think it'd be remiss of me if I didn't mention my friendly local vintage toy shop in Warwick, Metropolis Toys. And to echo Mark's sentiment, it's not a great time to be saddled with a shop and the high street rents when there's no one on the high street. So Metropolis Toys, vintage toys, high-end, high-grade, some quality stuff there, run by Chris Marlborough, who again probably a well-known name on the toy collecting circuit. Metropolistoys.co.uk is his website. It's not the most up-to-date website in the world, but you can find him on social media, search Metropolis Toys, and he's always kind of posting things on there, and you can buy remotely from Instagram and Facebook. So be supporting local bricks and mortar businesses.
I've bought a lot of Chris in recent times, as you full well know, Chris.
I do know.
yeah, he's had quite a bit of money off me recently. And like I say, mate, anybody with bricks and mortar shops these days needs absolutely every bit of support we can give them. And Chris is a good guy. What he's forgotten about toys is just not worth knowing, really. So, good luck to him. Oh, and Joe at Leicester Vintage Toys as well. Another good guy. Another bricks and mortar shop. He needs a good shout out as well. He's a lovely guy.
Yeah, agreed.
There you go. Get down and support these shops if you can this side of Christmas. Yeah, great shout outs. Very, very true. These people do need support. Dan, what have you come up with?
So I have got one more shop before we get into a few other things. So I've got the Jedi robe in Norfolk, which has been there for the last 10 years or so. I've just stuck a photo of it up. It's on the Target roundabout. I don't know if you drive into London that way and you go under the underpass, is a big McDonald's. It used to be the Target pub. And next to that is the Star Wars shop. The website is jedirobe.com. And primarily they do cosplay stuff. So if you're a cosplayer, they've got, every costume you could possibly imagine. But inside they've got loads of toys as well. So loads of Power of the Force, episode one, all the way through to today. And loads of oddities as well. I think I bought a hand carbonite ice cube tray in there one time, and all those kind of oddities, chopsticks, and all the kitchenwares you probably wouldn't find elsewhere. So yeah, it's a nice little shop. The guy who runs it, his name's Wayne. I've been in there a few times. I bought some vintage off him as well. It's definitely worth a visit if you can once it reopens. Or they have got the website as well, jedirobe.com. that was my first one. My second one, I suppose, just to get along more of the lines of the sort of stuff that Greg was talking about, I'll go with originalstormtrooper.com to start with. I don't know if you guys are aware of this guy at all. His name's Andrew Ainsworth. I think he cast the original Stormtrooper costumes for A New Hope for George Lucas. I think he cast 56 of them he was commissioned to. And then in the early 2000s, he found a mold that he had left over and started casting helmets again, which Lucasfilm weren't particularly happy about. They sued him for £20 million, went to the Supreme Courts in the UK. And I think in the 7 years it took to get there, George Lucas sold Lucasfilm to Disney, and Disney basically settled on, I think, $90,000 and allowed him to continue producing Stormtrooper helmets, which he seems to have gone a little bit beyond helmets. So he's doing quite a few different props and things like that. And he also has got a range of merchandise as well. On the website, there's obviously all of the helmets and things like that that he produces from the original molds that he's got. So he's got hero helmets and stunt helmets of the Stormtrooper. You can buy full sets of armor. He's also got Darth Vader helmets, Darth Vader busts, replica blasters. There's also, I think, TIE Fighter pilot helmets, Death Star gunner helmets. So if you're in the 501st, I think this is probably where a go-to place. The blasters that he does are all cast in resin, I believe. They weigh about 700 grams, so they're really light. And there's a note on there about they're great for trooping all day. So, and they're only 100, and I say only, but compared to some of the helmets that are like £200 or £300, some of them or more, the blasters are £199.99. So that doesn't feel like too bad of a deal with a stand. There's also a range of merchandise as well. So they do, with a Stormtrooper logo on it, they've got keychains, wallets, bottle opener, which we'll probably talk about again in a few weeks' time. And then they've also, they must have, and again, I don't know the ins and outs of it, but I think they must have some kind of licensing deal with the high street store Menkind. And if you go to the Menkind website, they've got a glass Stormtrooper helmet, which is a terrarium, a bit random. And they've also got some bookends, they've got a cookie jar, and they've also got, I really like, is a cheese board. So it's the Stormtrooper helmet shape, and you take the top off, and there's all kinds of knives and things in there to cut your cheese and crackers up on Christmas Eve. It was interesting as well reading up on some of that. I'd heard kind of bits and pieces that had gone on with this guy, and then yeah, it was good to kind of see it once it'd come full circle and see how it ended up. And he kind of came to relative peace with Disney. I don't know if any of this stuff is anyway licensed by Disney, but he's off making it.
This is where the Stormtrooper beer has come from as well, so it stems from this license.
Okay, so he's got like a free reign almost to use the Stormtrooper as a logo.
Be a long time before we see any officially Disney licensed beer.
Yeah, that makes sense, doesn't it? And then my last one is, I've been watching these on Facebook all summer, and I kept going on a website, and I was looking for a new barbecue, so I was really, really tempted by this. It's a website called Burn by Design. Again, this guy, he's off doing his own thing, and he is making, well, at the website itself, it covers a number of franchises. He's got wood burners and barbecues representing Alien, Terminator, and things like that, but it's the Star Wars ones that obviously we're interested in. I don't know if you guys have had a chance to look at any of these, but he's got some fantastic wood burners and barbecues going on. So there's a really nice Millennium Falcon grill for your back garden. He's got Darth Vader wood burners, R2-D2. He's got, what else is on there? There's a
Death Star's quite cool, isn't it?
The Death Star's cool. I really like the ATAT barbecue. That was the thing that originally caught my eye. So yeah, they're quite pricey, but you know, for something that's almost, well, I suppose they're all custom made, it's probably quite a good investment. It'll look great in your next door tiki bar, Stu, one of those, I reckon.
But even some of, like, they've got candlestick holders on there.
Yeah.
Like TIE Fighter candlestick holder and X-Wing and that. They are cool. I mean, you know, you just said a bit pricey. I mean, the ATAT barbecue, we're talking £1,539. They are on the rich side, let's be honest about it. It does say on their site their current lead time is running at 58 to 62 weeks.
I think your Stormtrooper and Boba Fett, though, they're what, 4 to 6 weeks? So you might
Fett
get one in time for Christmas.
And your Firestokers, yeah, 4 to 6 weeks. But they do look cool, mate. They do. I mean, R2-D2 pizza oven makes sense, doesn't it?
Yeah. You could look like Princess Leia bent over your R2-D2 pulling your pizza out.
Excuse me?
You know, when she puts, when she,
you
puts
be the, saying things like that.
A Death Star plan in the R2-D2.
You can bending over, pulling your pizza out.
I left myself wide open for that one.
Well, yeah, nice. They are cool. I mean, all of them are cool. I would be quite happy and content with anyone. Actually, the Fett wood burner, £439. That doesn't seem too bad. It looks quite cool once it's burning inside.
It suits the shape, doesn't it?
Yeah, looks right. I like the Vader as well.
Get one.
Yeah, I won't buy one of those while we're online. Candles at a tenner or one thing. Right, so I've come up with four. Now, something I me and my wife, we when Christmas is at home, we will make our own Christmas crackers and buy gifts for things. And I think these fit perfectly into that thing. Now, this is a company called Paracord Buddy. I don't know if you boys have seen these. Basically, these are things that can attach to your bags, your zips, your keys, anything like that. So they're made from paracord. They're folded in a way which creates a body. And then they have like a type of Lego head on. So at the moment, their range, they're $6.99 at the moment. And their range includes Stormtrooper, Mandalorian, Chewbacca, Vader, Fett, Yoda, Luke X-Wing, Stormtrooper, Kylo Ren, 3PO, Sith Trooper, Phasma. So quite a few. And then they've also got loads of Marvel and other ones. These are ideal for just tiny little things. And I think they're the perfect size for going in like a Christmas cracker if you've got someone who loves Star Wars or Marvel sitting around your table.
I've just looked at them. I can honestly say, having had a Star Wars Lego keyring for the last, oh, I don't know, 5-6 years, these are like they might survive being bashed around in your pocket and your bag a bit more than actual Lego keyrings.
As long as the knots don't come undone in your pocket, was my only concern.
Well, they might do that thing where they melt them a little bit, don't they? And they kind of seal them somehow.
Yeah. I mean, they've done well. So the paracord they've used, it's like the Mandalorian, for example, they've used like a dark green for his arms and brown for his body. So it looks, the Stormtrooper's completely white. Luke X-Wing's got an orange body. So they've made them look as much like the characters as they can. But yeah, I just thought a little bit of fun. Like I say, they've got plenty of superheroes if you're into that kind of thing. Most of the of those are on there as well. But
if you're giving away Christmas crackers like that, I'll come around your house.
Can't beat your own homemade Christmas crackers, especially when I write the jokes down.
Oh, yeah, that's a reason not to go.
I did like that. Now, my second one I want to bring up is a company called Truffle Shuffle. Have you ever heard of Truffle Shuffle?
Nope.
It's the Goonies, isn't it?
Well, exactly. So it's one of these kind of companies that does a bit of everything. But the thing I wanted to highlight on it was they've got a pizza cutter, which is shaped, so the handle is the Darth Vader's lightsaber hilt. But that's not the best thing, is because when you cut your pizza, it makes the noise of a lightsaber. I mean, it's $14.99.
I want one.
Exactly. You're holding a lightsaber, and every time you cut your pizza, it's going to go zhong. I mean, that to me is win-win.
All of a sudden, I'm eating a lot of pizza.
Just to cut it.
Yeah.
So hang on a minute.
It's from Funko, that. Yeah. It's a Funko product.
It is good.
I mean, if you look on Truffle Shuffle, there's... and just go to the Star Wars area. This is what the kind of site is. You've got Baby Yoda socks, lounge pants, Baby Yoda stress balls you can squeeze his head. And like I say, pyjamas for adults, Star Wars trivial games, all little bits. I will also point out, they've got a child drinking mug. Don't know if you can see this. Also from Funko, actually. Cup's half. In the side of it, where Baby Yoda's kind of sitting in his crib, there's a gap and you can keep your digestive biscuit in it. I mean, that's $11.99. I mean, that's incredible. I just think this is a great little gift area, which to me seems really reasonably priced. Yeah, seems like a no-brainer for me. We'll be doing my own personal Christmas shopping a bit on there, I think, as I treat myself to a few bits. Yeah, moving on. I just want to quickly do two more. Over on Etsy, there's a seller over there. It's called Unique Gifts by Blake. I'm going to use one of your boys' assumptions that these are made by someone called Blake. And I don't know whether there's quite a rage at the moment, isn't there? You go around to friends' houses, a lot of people have empty fancy drink bottles with some lights in it, fairy lights. Well, this bloke's basically doing the same sort of thing. He's getting clear empty bottles and then doing some quite cool pop culture kind of image on the side. There's a Star Wars one, which has got Darth Vader silhouette, and then it's got Yoda silhouette inside him, then R2-D2 silhouette inside Yoda, and then 3PO silhouette, and then Star Wars logo across the top with lights in. It's a great little thing. If you're having a Barbie in the summer, chuck that on the table outside when it gets a bit dark, sit around drinking. But they've got all sorts. Indiana Jones, Rocky, the Omens on there, if you're that kind of way inclined. It is on there. They've got all sorts on there. But yeah, they all retail at $13.95, free UK delivery. Again, seems quite a reasonably priced gift.
Nice.
I quite like the Buffalo Bill lotion light up bowl inspired by Silence of the Lambs. Put the lotion in the basket.
It's a bit cool. Now the final thing I wanted. Now these can retail, I think they're around 100 quid, but you can make yourself into a bobblehead or make your loved one into a bobblehead. And I'm not being funny. If I come into a bit of money, I will buy you all a Stuart bobblehead because I think you'll need it. I I mean, you choose your body type, you send a photo of your head, I think, and it modifies your head onto the doll. I just, who wouldn't want a bobblehead of themselves? Although it does remind me of the, I don't know if you boys ever watched Big Bang Theory, when they spend like $500 on an action figure of themselves and it turns up and it's basically just a kind of generic Indian and a generic Jewish bloke's figure. It looks nothing like them, but... they might turn out like that, but you've still got time. I think the turnaround's about 4 weeks for them. So all good fun. I think there's been some quite fun extra bits and pieces there for people to delve into.
Yeah, nice to look at something a bit different. And a lot of those are, you know, officially licensed products as much as we are.
Precisely, yeah, yeah. And I think before we even close out, I know he's not with us tonight. Jez is part of the podcast and he's been doing his 1,000-mile running challenge this year, even though he'd set a big target this year and was going to do all these events. But sadly, COVID has shut him down in places, and he has pressed on and carried on doing his 1,000 miles and carried on raising money for charities when they most needed it. And of course, his one of the best things he does to raise funds is the virtual medal series. Mark, you designed the medal for him, and the medals this year are quite amazing, aren't they? You incorporated a flashing light in it this year.
Yeah, we sort of took them to the next level this year. I did the ones for him last year and they were sort of dead straightforward really, but this year Jez's brief was a bit more exciting because we had a look at what we could actually do with the medals to take them to the next level, and we added little flashing lights to them, so the stormtrooper now looks like a target and the stormtrooper looks like it's firing his laser, his blaster. So yeah, they seem to have gone down really, really well, and they do look cool.
They do. There's a little button on the back. You can turn the light off, can't you? You can have it constantly flashing or permanently on. So they are cool. And also, you designed 4 different ribbons, didn't you, Mark? There's 4 different length of race you can do with these.
We did different artwork for each ribbon, basically like the colour of a lightsaber for each one. Similar thing that we did last year, but we changed the illustrations. And the ribbons themselves, you know... I'm just really pleased with how they've turned out. And I know Jez is really happy with how many they've sold. So we're in all, it's been a good project to work on.
Yeah, some of them sold out and they've already got a second run of each distance up. So what they were is you could, there's like Mark said, 4 different ribbons, and you could choose 1 mile, 5K, 100 miles or 1,000 miles. And you did it in your own time. You can walk, you could cycle it if you wanted, you could swim. So if anyone's looking for a little Christmas gift or perhaps something to do over December, these are £14. £5 goes straight to the charities, which is a huge help for Jez. And for that, you get out, do a bit of exercise, and then at the end of it, you get this medal waiting for you. So maybe sign the family up. Or do the 1 mile medal and go out for a walk on Christmas Day or Boxing Day, you know, just blow some cobwebs away. These are another great, great item. Limited run. Once they're gone, they're gone. Obviously, Jez's charity efforts really would also benefit massively. So you just need to go to myrace.run and you will find those medals on there. Just quickly, if there's one thing you could add that we've spoken to tonight, we know we love this question at the end of a modern. What would you be hoping under your tree, Dan?
Oh, a wood burner.
Wood burner. Yeah, okay. Mark?
The candles, I think, mate.
Nice, nice. Craig?
Lots and lots of lovely Star Wars beer.
Oh, that's a good shout. And I'm just going to go for the Ewok dress-up costume. Like we say, there's a few shows coming this month. We've got all sorts going on. Craig's already alluded to it. We've got a beer tasting show coming up. And that's, I mean, when we're putting together these podcasts, the team deciding who's going on what show, I think everyone would have liked to have done the beer tasting show. So it's been fiercely contested. But yeah, everyone's looking forward to that. Doing it on a weeknight, Craig.
It's just the way it's fallen, isn't it? I mean, it's
it is. I thought to myself, because I can't waste it after I've tasted it. So, yeah.
Another benefit of working from home.
Yeah. Well, sadly, some of us are still out there, Dan. So
we'll start. Never mind, eh?
If you want to leave us feedback or maybe drop some other ideas for Christmas presents that we may have forgotten, you can find us across all our social media, or Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. Just search for Generation Skywalker. Go over to YouTube. You'll find plenty of videos and enhanced versions of most of the shows. Again, just search for Generation Skywalker. You can find links to everything over on the website, www.generationskywalker.com. There's blog posts over there, and there is links to both the enhanced and the audio shows. So, boys, first show down. Looking forward to this festive season on Generation Skywalker. But it is for the first show. Good night from Craig.
Good night.
Good night from Mark.
Good night.
Good night from Dan.
Good night.
And slightly a bit different this month, we're going to play out with a Christmassy Star Wars song. So what better for the first show, all about presents, off the older Star Wars album from 78, whenever it was, What Do You Buy a Wookiee for Christmas? We are Generation Skywalker.
Let me see. We have a scarf for Skywalker, right?
Yes.
And perfume for the princess?
Yes. Yes,
what about Han Solo?
Couldn't we get him here?
All right.
That leaves one big problem.
The Wookiee.
Couldn't we get him a comb?
He gave him a comb last year.
Why can't you get a Wookiee for Christmas when he already owns a comb? Why can't you get in a hurry for a furry kind of friend like that?
Wrap it all up in bright colors, ribbon, and we give it to him all over again.